talking to my best friends, I'm working on excellence. Still ain't getting no playing time cause they was putting Seth in. But Liberty was still winning like Davidson and Steph in. My handles was the best then, pull up and make the net bend. Coach said you'll never check in if you don't know the O's and X's. I gotta perfect it.
Welcome to this brand new episode of Two.
The city of Charlotte, North Carolina. Now the opening lineup for the Oklahoma City Thunder. They've got Adams. Gallinari is out there with Horford. Then there's Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. And it's Jerome at the one. And for Charlotte, Washington and Zeller are in the middle. Monk is out there with Boss. And it's Bridges in at the three, the small forward. Here's Boss. Great for those teams that did make a deal with the trade deadline. How hard is it to integrate a new player mid-season?
Well, you know, guys who need the ball to be effective, it can be harder to integrate. But for certain role players, it's just how quickly they learn the system. So it's a tough call either way, especially if you have to go into a new environment where the terminology and everything's different. No doubt, my experiences in having guys traded to be a part of our teams, it was a tough transition for most of them.
Did you ever do it as a player?
I did it, yeah. And it's tough, you know. It's not just the teaming. I mean, you uproot it, you might have to leave your family if the kids are in school. I mean, there are a lot of factors that go into it that just don't revolve around what happens on the court.
So here's Gallinari following the basket by Malik Monk. Fade away. And it's Gallinari missing.
Well, he's a quality mid-range shooter, but he can't get that one to go.
Count that one.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
I think defensively, that is not the way you want to start. Giving up high percentage looks, that doesn't typically end well.
Here's Jerome after the made shot from Boss. Gallinari surveying the D. Shoots over Bridges. And again, no good by Oklahoma City.
That's another miss. Already they've missed 3 out of 4 to start.
That one falls. Boss has got his second basket.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Here's Jerome. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. Dishes to Gallinari. Shot clock at 6. They need this. And again, no good by Oklahoma City. Hornets have gone 4-4 to start. So a nice offensive rhythm to start here. And then Washington with the dunk.
Nice play, and you can see they're gathering momentum.
You want to continue to build on this lead. Right now, still a little too close for comfort.
And first timer of the game called for Oklahoma City.
Things not going their way, and he wants to just try to talk this one over.
Well, night in and night out, sometimes it's a battle of runs. Who has the most?
Outside. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. That one on Monk.
Well, the tremendous length at the guard spot that Shai Gilgeous-Alexander presents is a problem for a lot of defensive players.
A couple years ago, after making all-rookie second team, we knew Gilgeous-Alexander was good. But Greg, last season he went from good to great.
I mean, how about almost doubling his scoring average? Became a tremendous rebounder out of the backcourt. He gives you assists and picks up steals as well. Once he gains more strength, this guy could be a perennial all-star.
How about the confidence from three-point range by Shai Gilgeous-Alexander? Boy, if he likes the look, he will knock it down.
Here's Boss. He had a 21-point outing in their last game against the Celtics in Boston. Score the basket, his second of 2 attempts.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.